Dear students, in this video we can know about electromagnetic induction, that is physics 50A unit 2 chapter 4. In this chapter the contents are Faraday's laws, Lenz's law, cell phone mutual inductance, calculation of self inductance of long solenoid, energy stored in magnetic field, coefficient of coupling, transformer construction, working energy losses and efficiency. Okay, first of all I will explain about the induced EMF. Whenever magnetic lines of force are cut by a closed circuit, an induced current flows in the circuit and lasts only as long as the change in magnetic flux lasts. The induced EMF giving rise to such currents is called induced electromotive force. This phenomenon is called electromagnetic induction. It means whenever there is a relative motion between the magnet and the coil, we can observe electromotive force or induced current in the circuit. Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Whenever the magnetic flux linked with the circuit is changed, an EMF is induced in the circuit. The magnitude of induced EMF is directly proportional to the negative rate of variation of magnetic flux linked with the circuit. If phi b is the magnetic flux linked with the circuit at any instant and small e be the induced EMF, then e is equal to minus d phi b by dt. This is what is known as Newman's law, Lenz's law. In the above equation, the negative sign indicates the induced EMF opposite to the rate of change of or negative rate of change of the magnetic flux. This is explained by Lenz. According to Lenz's law, the direction of the induced EMF or current in a closed circuit is such that it opposes the original cause of that produces it. The law is based on the principle of conservation of energy. When the applied flux density in a closed circuit is increasing, the EMF induced in the closed circuit in such a direction as to produce a field, magnetic field, that tends to decrease magnetic flux density. On the other hand, when the applied flux density is increasing magnitude, the current in the closed circuit is in such a direction to produce magnetic field, which tends to increase magnetic flux density. Thus, the circuit is in such a direction to produce a magnetic field that opposes the cause of its generation, that is the applied magnetic field changing. The induced current is in a direction such that produces magnetic field or magnetic flux tending to oppose the original change of flux. So from this is tending to keep the total flux constant in the circuit. Suppose the north pole of the magnet moved towards the coil connected to a galvanometer. As the magnet is pushed towards the circuit, and a magnetic flux produced by the induced current to increase it. Right. Now depending on this electromagnetic induction, we can observe the self-inductance. When a current flows in a coil changes with time, an EMF is set up in the coil. This is what is called a self-induction. This is similar to inertia in mechanics. The induced EMF follows Lenz's law when the current switched on, self-induction opposes the growth of the current and vice versa. Means when the current switched off, self-induction opposes the decay of the current. This is shown in the graph also. We know that the magnetic flux induced around the coil carrying current I is directly proportional to the current. So, phi B proportional to I implies phi B is equal to some constant L into I. The proportionality constant L is called coefficient of self-induction or self-inductance of the coil. When I is equal to 1 unit, then phi B is equal to L. And the coefficient of self-inductance is numerically equal to the magnetic flux linked with the coil when unit current flows through it. We know the induced EMF is equal to minus d phi b by dt. So that minus d by dt of Li, which is equal to minus L di by dt. The negative sign indicates that the induced EMF, that is self-induced EMF, is in such a direction as to oppose the change. When di by dt is equal to 1 unit, then E is equal to minus L. From this we can define self-inductance also. The coefficient of self-inductance is numerically equal to the induced EMF in the coil when the rate of change of current is unity. When the rate of change of current is unity. Self-inductance of long swan lead. Consider a long air core solenoid of length L meter, uniform cross section area A square meter. Let small n be the number of turns per meter. Let a current I ampere flows through it. The magnetic field inside the solenoid is given by, already I taught in the last chapter, B is equal to mu naught Ni Weber per meter square, where mu naught is the permeability, which is constant. So the magnetic flux linked with all the turns of the solenoid will be, that we will get by knowing the magnetic flux through each turn, that phi b or d phi b is equal to ba mu naught Ni a Weber. So the magnetic flux linked with all turns of the solenoid is equal to mu naught In into total number of turns, where N is equal to the number of turns in the solenoid, which is equal to, that's capital N is equal to smaller number of turns per unit length into length of the solenoid. Thus the self-inductance of the solenoid is therefore, by comparing the above equation with phi B is equal to Li, L is equal to mu naught N square A L. Mu naught, right. Energy stored in the magnetic field. Consider a very long solenoid of length L and a cross-sectional area A. When current flows in it, a magnetic field is established. This field is uniform inside the solenoid and negligible outside the solenoid. So the volume associated with the solenoid is equal to length into cross-sectional area. Or the volume associated with the magnetic field also equal to length into cross section area. We have seen that the amount of work done in establishing a constant current in the solenoid is half L I naught square, where L is the self inductance of the solenoid. The work done is stored in the form of energy in the magnetic field. So work done is half L I naught square, so the energy stored is equal to half L I naught square. But we know the self inductance of a solenoid, L is equal to mu naught N square A L, where N is the number of turns per unit length, A is the cross section area, and L is the length of the solenoid small l. Right. Therefore, by substituting the value of L in the above equation, The energy stored is equal to half mu naught n square A L into I naught square, which is equal to half mu naught n I naught square, that is mu naught n I naught whole square by mu naught into A L. We know magnetic field inside the solenoid B is equal to mu naught n I naught. So that this is equal to half B square A L by mu naught. So the energy density is equal to B square by 2 mu naught. Coefficient of mutual induction. Consider two coils placed nearer to each other. When a current changed in the primary coil P, there is a change of magnetic flux linked with it. That magnetic flux linked with the nearby coil also. An induced EMF is set in the secondary coil as this phenomena is called as mutual inductance. This mutual inductance or this mutual induced EMF follows Lenz's law. As shown in the figure, the current that flows through the coil initially is known as primary coil, and the coil which is useful to get induced EMF is called as, without any generator, is called as secondary coil. Let a current I ampere is passing through primary coil that produces a magnetic flux phi B in the secondary coil S. Yes. For two given coils situated in fixed relative positions, it is observed that the flux linked with the secondary coil is directly proportional to the current in the primary coil. So phi B is proportional to I, or phi B is equal to MI. The M is constant M is known as coefficient of mutual inductance or mutual inductance of the two coils. This induced EMF also follows Faraday's law. So induced EMF E is equal to minus d phi B by dt. By substituting the value of phi B, E is equal to minus d by dt of MI, which is equal to minus M di by dt. From first and second equations, we can define the mutual inductance in the following two ways. When I is equal to 1, then phi B is equal to M. So mutual inductance is defined as the flux linked with a circuit due to a unit current flowing through the nearby circuit. And from the second equation, when di by dt is equal to minus 1 unit per second, then E is equal to M. So mutual inductance is also defined as the EMF induced in the circuit when the rate of decay of current in the other circuit is unity. The unit of mutual inductance or self-inductance is Henry. So it is defined the mutual inductance of two circuits when the current changing in at the rate of 1 ampere per second in one circuit, which induces 1 volt EMF in the other circuit. Coefficient of coupling. Consider two coils very close to each other and having the number of turns small n1 and small l2 per unit length. Let I1 and I2 be the currents in the circuits. By the definition of self-inductance, phi is equal to Li, which is equal to number of turns into the flux associated with the each link. So L1 is equal to N1 phi 1, L2 is equal to N2 phi 2 by I2. Phi 1 and phi 2 are magnetic fields linked with the coils 1 and 2 due to their own currents I1 and I2 respectively. When a current I1 is passing through the first coil, there will be a magnetic flux linked with each turns of the second coil. Let it be phi 2n, that is magnetic flux linked with the second coil with respect to the current in the first coil. So the total magnetic flux linked with n turns of the second coil will be n2 phi 2n. Suppose the coefficient of mutual inductance of second coil due to the current in the first coil is m21, then n2 phi 2n is equal to m21 i1. Similarly, due to a current I2 in the second coil, there will be a magnetic flux linked with each turn of the first coil. Let it be phi 12. Then the total flux linked with n1 turns of the primary or first coil will be n1 phi 12. Suppose the coefficient of mutual inductance of first coil due to the current in the second is m12, then n1 phi 12 is equal to m12 i2. If two coils are wound on the same core, so that the center magnetic flux set up by each coil links with all the turns of the other, then the coupling is said to be perfect. It means phi 1t is equal to phi 2 and phi 2 1 is equal to phi 1. This situation is known as maximum flux linkage situation. In this situation, by applying reciprocity theorem, m1t is equal to m21, which is equal to m maxima. Applying the conditions 5 and 6 to equations 3 and 4, we get n2 phi 1 is equal to m maxima i1, n1 phi t is equal to m maxima i1 i2. So multiplying these two equations, m maxima square i1 i2 is equal to n1 i2 phi 1 phi 2. By substituting the values of phi 1 phi 2, m maxima square is equal to n1 phi 1 by i1 into n2 phi 2 by i2, which is equal to l1 l2, or m maxima is equal to l1 l2. This equation is true only when the pole of the effective flux from one coil links with the other. It means the total of the effective flux from one coil with the other coil. In actual practice, the above condition is never fulfilled, or in general, only a fraction of flux is linked with one coil due to the current in the other coil. Now we can express the mutual inductance between the two coils as M is proportional to root L1 L2, or M is equal to K into root L1 L2. The K is called as coefficient of coupling between the two coils. The value of K varies from 0 to 1 and depends upon the geometrical shape of the coils and their relative positions and the core that we can use. If K is equal to 1, the coupling is tight and there is no leakage of flux. If K is equal to 0, then there is no coupling between the coils. If K greater than 0 and K less than 1, there is optimum coupling. There is optimum. Now we will discuss about transformer. A transformer is an AC static device which transforms electrical power from one circuit to another circuit. It can raise or lower the voltage in a circuit, but with a corresponding decrease or increase in current without changing the frequency. It is working on the principle of mutual inductance. When an alternating voltage is applied to the primary coil, an alternating current is set up in it. As the winding is linked with a magnetic EMF, it produces an alternating in the core. This alternating magnetic flux links with the turns of the secondary coil. So it induces a mutual induced EMF in the secondary coil with the same frequency of the flux. This also follows Faraday's law. EMF equation. You know that the primary voltage VI is absorbed in the circulating the primary current against the EMF induced by the main flux. The EMF is given by the rate of change of flux. So E is equal to minus N d phi by dt volts. Here E is the instantaneous value of EMF induced in volts. Phi is the instantaneous value of magnetic flux, that is mutual flux. And N is the number of turns in the coil. When the applied voltage is sinusoidal, so that the magnetic flux that produced is also sinusoidal in the core. The equation of that magnetic flux phi is equal to phi m sin omega t, where omega is equal to 2 pi f t, f is the frequency of the supply. This alternating flux induces a self-induced EMF in the primary coil and a mutual induced EMF in the secondary coil. Let N1 and N2 are the number of turns of P and S respectively. From equation 1, E maxima is equal to N1 phi m 2 pi f volts. So ERMS is equal to E maxima by root 2, which is known as E1 or EP 2 pi f N1 phi m by root 2. So E1 is equal to 4.44 phi m N1 into f volts. This is known as EMF equation of the transformer. Similarly, we can write the induced EMF. E2 is equal to 4.44 phi m N2 f. Let us now define the term transformer ratio. Dividing the above two equations, E1 by E2 is equal to N1 by N2 is equal to A. This is what is called as transformer ratio. What is the efficiency of a transformer? Generally, we know the efficiency is divided by output by input. Here, the output power by input power. So, efficiency eta is equal to V2I2 by V1 into I1. Now, the transformer losses, iron losses, copper losses, hysteresis losses, eddy current losses, stray losses, and dielectric losses. The physical phenomena losses occur to the takes to the variation of the magnetization within the core of the transformer, and also the copper loss occur because of the transformer winding resistance. Thank you, one and all.